I know that when you come to the event, you spoke about the CBD oil, and you're a great believer in CBD. Can you tell me why you believe in CBD?
Well, I took it initially because I thought it would help with my anxiety, which it didn't particularly do help that much with the anxiety. But it did help with my sexual life, which is pretty great.
That's amazing.
So I think that's, you know, an added bonus.
Great bonus.
Because it doesn't, you know. So if it does help with anxiety, maybe to a certain degree it might. I don't know, but it definitely helped me. I know that a lot of women suffer from dryness and just not wanting to, and that really helped me get into more moist.
Because CBD lubricants now, isn't it? Yeah.
Well, no, it was just oil. I just took no oil, and it just made my body, you know, a lot.
Do you think it has changed? Relaxed you?
If it relaxed me, I just, because I get a panic attack, so in that sense it didn't really work. But I haven't, because I've been away on holiday, or just scared to take it with them. You never know what the rules are.
Of course,
places,
yes,
you know,
absolutely.
You know,
yeah.
They'll qualify this.
But you would try balms and creams and different. You would try.
No, I just had the oil. I just tried the oil, and I found that really useful.
Really, that's interesting, because we do get lots of emails from ladies asking about the different CBD oils, the different CBD creams,
the
normal
oil that you put
under your tongue. Oh, right, okay, that's interesting.
Yeah. Well, I could literally feel within a few days that I just, you know, my whole body just felt more
responsive.
Just kind of more moist. I don't know. Just, you know, your skin dries, everything dries, and then it just, that kind of helped with dryness everywhere, both inside and out.
Interesting.
If that makes sense.
Yeah. Well, maybe it's because you were relaxed slightly, and that you're able to just sort of loosen up and relax.
No, but it just literally helped.
You looked.
Yeah, it helped on the skin. So it helps.
That's interesting.
So I don't know if that was just a side effect of it. I mean, it relaxed me as much as I thought it would, but it was.
So that's what we're finding, more that more women are taking CBD oil, not just for relaxation, but obviously for their sleep, because that is one of the biggest symptoms that we get, sleep. But I think it's all connected, isn't it? Your sleep pattern, then you get your panic attacks, you get the anxiety, and if you haven't had a good sleep, it all goes hand in hand.
And then food, and then workout, and the whole thing. It's all, and we've got to really, really take control of ourselves and be very strict. I mean, I've been on holiday now for 2 weeks with a friend who is going through terrible symptoms, in the sense that she's put on a huge amount of weight in the last few months, doesn't understand why. But apparently has been told by her therapist that it's mainly to do with it, just anxiety of her, you know, losing control. So she, observing her for 2 weeks, I could see, you know, that she's just eating really, really badly. Like, she would go for the white bread every time, and then pretend she hasn't eaten anything.
Absolutely.
And, you know, and you would, and then drink lots of wine, and, you know, and kind of like, do you know, it was
it's
just
the
not...
the sugar, it's the white
bread.
Yeah,
it was
bread,
just like, and then she would feel really shit, and then, you know, and it would be like, she doesn't understand why. She's like, well, I'm not eating anything. And it's like, well...
But you are,
and you're eating the wrong things. And if you try to eat, you know, the right things, this might not be as much fun, and it, you know,
because you do get that, you do get the sugar rush. I was speaking earlier on, we tend to have that sugar rush at a certain time in the evening. I know I get it, so I've gone into the pea protein shakes, which actually suppresses the sugar, because I love
it. So my gym has put me on a very strict diet where I'm not allowed any natural, well, processed sugar. So my treat will be straight to a vegan peanut butter, natural.
And how are you finding coming out of the sugar? It's like a sugar detox. Is that helping your perimenopausal symptoms? Or
I don't know. I haven't been on it long enough. I've just managed to get over the headache. It's followed
well,
with
that,
the
that
sugar.
Must be working then.
Yeah.
That is one of the main,
So
you're on the right track. So you're actually preparing yourself for the menopause.
Yes. But I do think that it's, you know, I mean, my trainer was like, when I was complaining about my headache, he's like, do you want to continue? And I'm like, yes, of course. Like, you know, it's just a headache. It will go away. Know, it's a pain in the arse, and I'm whinging about it now, you know, and I'm moaning, and I'm really pissed because I can't go to the gym. But I'm enjoying, you know, I never used to love going to the gym, but I feel the benefits tremendously. I feel I had a knee injury a few years ago, and it's just made everything so much stronger. I go skiing every year, and I had a lot of knee injury from skiing, so just skiing into me. And now when I go skiing, I don't feel anything. You I just feel the benefit.
Well, it's good
that
you know that that is what you have to do. I mean, we say to a lot of women, just keep it mobile. Even if you're walking, you've got
it's
to keep
so,
mobile.
It's just amazing. And really, honestly, like everything just, I might not, you know, I haven't lost as much weight as I would love to and built the lovely muscles that I would, you know, maybe 10, 20 years ago I would do by working as much out as I do now. But my benefit, like my veins and my legs have gone away from working out, like just completely, you know, not expected, but
so
really great.
So it's pushed you into other things?
My blood pressure has gone down. You know, I used to have chronic blood pressure, which was a genetic thing, and I was 20 years ago told that all you have to be on pills for the rest of your life. I did all the tests. I wasn't fat then, and I wasn't, you know, so I wasn't overweight. I didn't have any specific reasons, and it was just genetic. They did all the tests on me, and that's gone down.
So you know it's diet and exercise. You know it has to be. You have to compromise.
It just, you know, so that's just naturally happened. I'll go to the doctor now, and I'll do my blood test, and they'll be like, normal. And I'll be like, wow, I haven't had a normal blood test.
That's
or normal blood pressure for like 25 years. So. You know, there's small, I think,
changes.
We have to do it. We have to do it. We have to force ourselves to do it, basically. I think that's really, really important. That's always, you know,
you're
it's
doing
hard.
Really well. That's fantastic. Yeah.
Why don't